yell at me.
I will yell at you.
Keep walking.
What, what's crazy? There's no dog on the grass.
Oh my gosh.
Keep filming. We can be here all day.
You're overreacting, Karen.
My dog is not on a leash. And oh, you can't read English apparently. Let's go.
Why? Because I'm Asian. Are you racist?
You can't read English.
Are you racist? Are you racist?
Oh, apparently you don't have to do anything that Americans have to do. Okay, so you can't read.
Why don't you go yell at other people that have dogs on the grass?
I can't understand a word you say. Speaking English? Because apparently you don't know that you have to have a leash on your dog.
It's the same woman. It's the same crazy woman. She's just, she might be the ultimate Karen because she just goes out all day, every day to mess with people. Non-white people, generally. This is apparently an Asian American who she declares is not American, Francesca. This woman, and by the way, we had already alluded to, she was filmed harassing these skateboarders, trying to stop them. Like, she never takes a day off from Karening.
And this happens all the time. I mean, thinking about the instances that are not being filmed, because it does take a lot of bravery to actually take out your phone and film. You know, everyone has been in a situation where tensions are running high, and you're like, I can only imagine how much her heart was racing, feeling like she was being accosted for no reason because she was Asian. And immediately saying other Americans.
Yeah.
You know, can you not read because you don't speak English? She's talking to you in English. And I like, it is deeply painful and just fascinating. First of all, a lot of anti-Asian hate and anti-Asian hate crimes have been mischaracterized as happening by people of color against Asians, like by Black Americans against Asian Americans. That's not actually true. The majority of hate crimes against Asians have been done by white people. So let's just dispel that. And here you have someone, and this is the other thing, it's like, it can range from stabbing to assaulting to, you know, to following. But then there's just this like rando tennis lady, tennis Karen. Go to tennis. Go play tennis. What are you doing? And like, that's the other thing, is like, I'm scratching my head. And maybe people who know folks like this can comment and understand the psyche. Is this someone with a mental health issue? Is this someone, or is this just a racist, right? And why are we doing this? And arguably, like, and this is the thing, I mean, I'm reminded of Sarah Cooper. Sarah Cooper and the woman in Central Park against, you know, the bird watcher. And how she like very much projected like a liberal, you know, sentiment, like, oh yeah, that she might have voted for Obama twice. Like, there's a lot of get out energy from these white Karens. There's a lot of like maybe even voted for Hillary energy from these white Karens. And so I ask like my like white liberal, like, you know, folks out there, like, come get your girls, come get your moms, come get your aunties. Like, what are they doing? What are they not happy about? Did you not call them?
I guess. And everybody has to have a hobby. Some people put together 7-point plans to get Trump reelected. Other people harass strangers in a park all day long. I mean, everybody also wants to go viral. Maybe she's found a shortcut. She knows that she will. Maybe she likes it. Maybe she just delights in the view numbers.
This is her TikTok.
This is her TikTok, unfortunately. And I know that, like, so as we did with the last one, we'll say, look, yes, you're supposed to have your dog on a leash. And let me just follow that up by saying, and I don't care in this context, because having your dog on a leash is not in the same ballpark as racially harassing people, pretending they have accents that they don't, implying that they're not true Americans because you don't like what race or national origin you think they have. When all of that is out there, I stop caring so much about the leashes.
It wasn't Sarah Cooper. Sarah Cooper's a wonderful comic. It's Amy Cooper is her name. I apologize.
Okay, there you go. And you talked about the woman, like, she must have been scared with this woman coming there. Yeah, she had a tennis racket. And we know that a lot of this anti-Asian American harassment in New York City results in people beating the person that they're harassing or attempting to kill them, as has happened. So That woman with her tennis racket could have been hitting this woman with her tennis racket at any time. And by the way, like, we've now covered this woman twice, maybe we'll in the future, but there's like a little kernel inside of me that's thinking, is she gonna shoot someone someday? Is she gonna knife someone someday? Like, at what point is just shouting at them not enough for a woman so driven by racial animus? I hope that I'm wrong. I hope it never gets any worse than it is now, as bad as it already is. But I am a little bit worried about that. Like, people move on from like domestic violence to murder, like stalking to worse. Like, that is how people work. And so I'm worried about this woman.
Yeah, I mean, it's part of a racist ecosystem and an anti-Asian ecosystem, but yeah. I think which I think is important to recognize, because when there are mass shootings, I think that you know, hashtag not all Karens are like, you know, would support something like that. But it is important to see the different gradations and the different levels of violence, yeah, like harassing someone in a park, you know, like calling them not American for no reason other than the fact that they're Asian, because it allows us to see that slippery slope and understand that ecosystem of hate.
Yeah. By the way, Megan in the chat says she got her white belt in Karenate.
Wow. Jesus.
It definitely would be a white belt.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.